Hi learners, welcome you all to the 35th module of school counseling. This module is on special concerns of school counselor, the need and importance for early identification and planning suitable intervention. A simple proverb, a stitch in time saves nine, is very similar to the concept of early identification and intervention. The term early identification does not reflect just early years of life, but it is more about recognizing or acknowledging difficulties or problems at the earliest and making a quick intervention to guide the children and their families so that the problem or the issue can be nipped in the stage of bud itself and before they become more deep-rooted problem. Early identification and intervention then can be equated with prevention. The discipline of human development believes in optimizing the potentials with which children are born. This requires healthy child rearing practices to be adopted by parents. Children born with physical or mental disabilities, developmental delays and disabilities or other issues are in the dire need of support and help. Researchers on brain development suggest that earlier is better. The role of school counselor is very critical. School psychologists can provide the educators with a scientific framework for determining if a child is on track and for interpreting rate of development relative to assessment area. The school counselors plays a major role in counseling the parents, teachers, and the affected child and brings them on the same platform for the benefit of child. With this backdrop, the module on concerns of school counselor will be taken further by the following. Number 1, identification and intervention. Number 2, classification of types of issues and concerns. Number 3, intervention strategies for the major concerns. The learning objectives of this video would be to understand the concept and importance of early identification and intervention. Children are special in their own way. Children have their own strong points and weaknesses. The rate of development is different from different individuals. It is obvious that children may show proficiency in some areas and may lag behind in some. However, if children reveal palpable difficulties and issues in one or more than one area of development and their accomplishments shows notable differences when compared with other children of same age, it becomes mandatory to send the child for additional assessment. Intervention is an amalgamation of various components, constituents, and strategies to bring about desirable changes in the behavior or health of an individual. Psychoeducational programs, robust policies, and enhancing the environment are some of the elements of intervention. Intervention that employ more than one strategy are generally the most effective in producing needed and enduring changes. Intervention brings about changes by stimulating knowledge, attitude, beliefs, and skills of the individual, providing social support and establishing a supportive environment and framing policies and making resources available. The three levels of intervention includes primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary intervention is organized within regular school education and includes lesson plan based on school curriculum. Regular monitoring of the child is done. Based on their results, further instructions are given. Monitoring helps in identifying students who are not progressing and who need additional instructions. Secondary intervention includes the use of additional programs. Students' needs are thoroughly addressed. In tertiary level, some students are taken in for special education. At this level, specific intervention is given and every week the progress is recorded and scrutinized. Teaching is customized to the child's need. One of the major roles of school counselor is to support and help children who are having special needs, that is, to identify issues and impairments. And they have them screened, assessed, and then develop a plan for strategies so that the child is able to cope up and lead a fulfilling life. In the process of growth and development, children encounter learning difficulties, but these difficulties are temporary and can be easily handled with the help and encouragement from parents and teachers and others. But there are children who experiences severe learning difficulties and are unable to manage as other children can manage. These children can be said to have special educational needs and are in the need of special extra help from that according to their age mates. These children may face problems in one or more of the following areas. Number one, thinking, comprehending and studying. Generally, these children face difficulties with all educational activities, reading, writing, spelling, mathematics or some learning activities they find difficult. Second one, speech, language and communication. These difficulties are generally associated with an inability in expression and comprehension. They may face problems related to producing speech sounds or voice quality. Third one, emotional difficulties. These children may suffer from anxiety, shyness, fears, low self-esteem and lack of confidence. Fourth is behavioral difficulties. These children may present disrupted and disturbed behavior. Fifth one is physical or sensory difficulties. A medical condition or a disability which influences learning, that is, these children may have a visual or hearing impairment. The above difficulties are some of the special concerns of the school counselor. I hope we have understood in a nutshell about the concept and importance of early identification and intervention. In the following videos, let us see the issues and concerns of children and adolescents.